So today we are going to learn load store instructions in ARM processor. So what are these load store instructions? Load store instructions, they transfer the data between memory and the processor registers. So there are three types of load store instructions. The first one is single register transfer, multiple register transfer, and third one is swap instruction. So let us see what is single register transfer load store instructions. So what are these instructions? These instructions, they copy the data from memory to the register or from register to the memory. So what is the syntax? If you want to copy the data from memory to the register, you have to use LDR instruction. If you want to copy the data from register to the memory, then STR instruction is used. So again, here the condition is optional, and you can prefix LDR with B or H depending upon what data you want to access. Either you want to access the full 32-bit data, then use only LDR. If you want to access only the 16-bit data from the memory to the register, then use H prefix to the LDR. The same thing applies for STR instruction. And RD is nothing but the destination register, which the data has to be copied from memory to the register. Addressing 1 or 2, these indicates these are the different addressing modes where you can copy the data from memory to register. So let us see what are the different various ways of using LDR or STR. So that is what I told, the LDR, if I specify, that means you are copying only the 32-bit data from memory to the register. If I say only LDRB, then you are copying only 8-bit data from memory to the register. If I say LDRH, then you are copying half word data from memory to register. Similarly, if I say only STR, that means you are copying only 32-bit data from the register to the memory. If I say STRB, then you are copying 8-bit data from register to the memory. If I say STRH, then you are copying half word data from register to the memory. So let us understand these instructions with an example. So first we will see the LDR instruction. So here the example is given that there is an address 9000. From in that memory location, you can see on the left right hand corner the data 0x, that means the data is preceded with hexadecimal, but in the memory the data are stored in hexadecimal. So here 32-bit data is existing. The data is 01010101. So this data I want to copy it into the register RO. So how it is written? LDR RO. So here RO is basically holding the zero value. R1 is the memory location address which the register R1 is pointing. So from this memory location I have to copy the data. So here you have to write indirect addressing mode, that means you have to put a square bracket. So when I execute this instruction from the memory location R1, that is 32-bit data is copied into the register RO. So you can see that RO is now holding 01010101. Suppose you have decided like I want to copy only the 8-bit data, then what you have to write? LDRB RO comma R1 address should be written in square bracket. That means when I precede LDR with a B, that means from the memory location only the 8-bit data from the LSB, that is 01, is copied into the register RO. If I say LDRH, that means I am copying 16-bit data from the memory. So when I say LDRH RO comma R1 in the square bracket, that is 0101, that is 16-bit data is copied into the register RO. So next we will see the LDR instruction, how it can be used with the different addressing modes. Addressing modes are nothing but how you can copy the data from memory to the location. What are the various ways you can copy the data from memory to the register? So first we will see the pre-index with the write back. Let us take an example here. The R1 is pointing to the memory location 9000. It is holding 0101 value. But I don't want to copy that data. I want to go to the next memory location 9004 and copy the data. So sometimes in programming you have to copy the data in a loop one by one from the memory location. That time these addressing modes will come into picture. So here what is written, LDR RO comma, in the square bracket you are writing R1 comma hash 4 and exclamation mark. This is nothing but pre-index with the write back. That means the address, base address is already pointed by R1. To that you have to add hash 4. Hash 4 is nothing but the offset 4. Add 4. So now the base address will point to 9004. From that memory location, what data is there? 0x, that is 0202 data is there. That data you copy it into the register RO. And what this exclamation marks indicates, that means the register R1 address is also updated. So now R1 is also pointing to 9004. So we can see in the memory location R1 is pointing to 9004, and also the data from that is copied into the register RO. The next addressing mode is pre-indexing. So one you can see that here there is no exclamation mark. What do you mean by that here? So let us see the example here. The LDR RO comma, in the bracket I have written R1 comma hash 4. There is no exclamation mark. That means the address, the base address is not updated here. So initially the R1 is pointing to the 9000 memory location. To that the offset address 4 is added. So it will go to 9004 memory location, and from that memory location the data 0202 is copied into RO, but the base address R1 is not updated if exclamation mark is not written. So that address is nothing but pre-indexing. So next, what is the third addressing mode? That is called post-indexing. The post-indexing address is nothing but whatever there is there in the base address, copy that data into the register and increment or go to the next memory location by adding offset. So let us see an example here. RO is having the value 0. R1 is pointing to the memory location 9000. So in this location the data 0101 32-bit data is existing. This data I want to copy into the register RO. So here what it will do, if I write only in the square bracket, R1 is written only in the square bracket, that means it will copy the data from that memory location to the RO, and later the address is updated by adding 4. So now the R1 is pointing to 9004. But in the register RO, the base address, whatever the value it is there in that memory location, is copied into RO. So this is how LDR instruction is used with a different addressing mode. So let us go to the next one, that is STR instruction. So let us take an example here. STR instruction is basically, it is used, that is the data that is existing in the register, I want to store back it into the memory. So I have taken pre is nothing but before executing the instruction, the register RO is having the value of 32-bit data value of 1234. I want to copy this data into the memory location pointed by R1, that is 9000. So how it is written? So first you write STR instruction. The RO is where the register holding the data, comma, where you want to copy the data into memory, that address should be written in square bracket. So I have written here R1 in the square bracket. So when this instruction is executed, what happens? The 1234 data is copied into the memory location 9000. You can see in the memory location 9000, the data 1, 2, 3, 4 is copied. Suppose you have decided to copy only 8-bit data. Then how you have to use? STR, precede it with the B. When I say STRB RO, comma in the square bracket R1, that means only 34, that is 8-bit data, is copied into the memory location 9000. Next we will see how this STR instruction can also be used with a different addressing mode. So first we will see pre-index with the write back. So sometimes in programming you have to copy the data into memory location one by one. So that time these addressing modes will come into the picture. So first we will see pre-index with the write back. Assume that the RO is having the value 4567. This data I want to copy into the memory location 9004. So here what is written? STR RO comma in the bracket R1 comma #4 and again exclamation mark is written. That means the R1 is having the base address 9000. To this 9000 the offset 4 is added. That means now the memory location will be pointing to 9004. So now what happens? Whatever the data RO is having 4567, this is copied not into 9000, it is copied into 9004 memory location. And also what the exclamation mark indicates, the R1 address is updated here. So next we will see the pre-indexing. The pre-index is nothing but here the data is written into the next memory location, but there is no exclamation mark. So let us see an example here. The register RO is having the value 1234. So this data I want to copy into the memory location 9004. So what you do? Write STR RO comma in the square bracket you write R1 comma #4. The R1 is pointing to 9000. To this base address the offset 4 is added. Now it is pointing to 9004. In this memory location the data 1234 is copied. So that you can see after the execution of the instruction in the memory location 9004 is updated with the value 1234. But one thing you can see that the register R1 is not updated. It is pointing to the same base address. So the last addressing mode we can see is the post indexing. The post indexing is also one type of addressing mode where you can store the data. But here in the base address the data is copied and after that the address is incremented by the offset. So let us see an example here. The register RO is having 1234. So this data I have to copy it into the base address 9000. So how it is written? STR RO comma in the square bracket you have to write R1, it is an indirect addressing mode, means in this memory address I have to copy the data 1234. Then after that comma #4 is written. What it indicates? Now in the base address 9000 the data is copied 1234 and after that the address 9000 is added with the offset 4 and now the R1 is pointing to the memory location 9004. So these are the different addressing modes which we can use with the LDR and STR instructions. Thank you.